every day, morning and evening, 1 hour in the morning, 1 hour in the evening, minimum. You have to water it. A new student sometimes feels very hesitant. 2 hours of my day? I am such a busy person. How can I spare 2 hours every day? Oh no, this is too much. Initially, it looks too much. It is not too much. For the first 1 year, you have to take a very strong adhisthana, strong decision. Let me lose anything at the mundane level, I don't care. But I will practice every day, morning and evening, 1 hour, 1 hour. And you won't lose anything. This is only to have a strong decision, adhisthana. Initial difficulties will be there. Like coming to a course on the fourth day, you are given adhisthana. For 1 hour you don't change your position, your posture. So much difficult. And practicing within 10 days, you start sitting easily. So also, initially you will have difficulty. How to spare 1 hour in the morning, 1 hour in the evening. But having this strong determination, within 1 year you find it becomes so easy. And after that it becomes so easy in life. It won't take even 1 year to realize that it is so easy. You will start understanding that I am not wasting 2 hours of my life, 2 hours of my day, every day. Your capacity to work will increase. Your time given to sleep will decrease. Those who are accustomed to sleep, say, 8 hours every night will now 7 hours, enough. Those who sleep 7 hours, they will find 6 hours, enough. Those who sleep 6 hours will find 5 hours, enough, not necessary. So 1 hour you can easily take out of your sleep. And even when you get awakened, are you really awakened? Lying here lazy, lying there lazy, so much time is wasted in that. With a vipassana, for a vipassana meditator, every moment is so valuable. Can't afford to waste time, you will be active. As soon as you wake up, you are active with your responsibilities, with your daily responsibilities. And the capacity will certainly increase. Anyone in any profession, any means of livelihood, will find that the capacity to work has increased so much. Before practicing vipassana, if one used to work 8 hours per day, at the end of 8 hours one felt so exhausted, so tired. Practicing vipassana morning and evening, whatever work one used to finish in 8 hours, now it is over in 7 hours, in 6 hours, and yet feels so fresh, feels like working more. The capacity increases. Case of my own teacher, Syaji Ubakhin, a wonderful person. When Burma became independent, he was made the first accountant general of Burma. He was born in a very poor family. The family had no money to give him higher education. He just had education of high school and then started doing service here and there. Got a very junior clerk's job in the accountant general's office. And by his hard work, perseverance, he reached a certain stage, a junior officer, when Burma became independent. And naturally, independent Burmese government wanted their own nationals to be heads of different departments. And most of the departments were headed by Britishers or Indians, etc. In the accountant general's office, they found this person, Ubakhin, although a very junior officer. He was the only Burmese officer, so they made him the accountant general, the first accountant general of Burma. Before he reached that stage, he had started practicing vipassana. When he was a junior clerk, he heard that on the other bank of the river there is a teacher, a farmer, who is teaching vipassana. Anybody who has got seed of vipassana from the past, a seed of Dhamma from the past, cannot resist. As soon as one hears vipassana, oh, it is for me. I better go and try. And this started happening in him. I must go and try. This is wonderful. But the high officials won't give him 10 days leave. They say this is the time of budget. Every staff is needed so much, so badly. We can't give you leave. And he says, but I have to go. You even cut my salary for 10 days. No, nothing doing. You can't go. If you go, you will be dismissed from the service. He can't resist. He went. He went away. After 10 days, in 10 days, because of his past paramis, he reached such giddy heights in Vipassana, practiced so much. But when he came back, there was a doubt that perhaps he will be dismissed. Came to the office, and yes, on his table there was the envelope, official envelope. He opened it. And this message says that you are promoted. Now you have become the superintendent of the office, chief superintendent. Your salary goes 50% high. This does not mean that everyone who come here will get a letter of promotion. Who knows, there are cases, people keep on writing me that after coming back from the course I got this, I got that. But this is not a guarantee, it happens in different cases. It happened in the case of Uba Kenan, then he kept on getting promotion after promotion. He became Accountant General of Burma. And the Accountant General's office, like many other offices, lot of corruption, lot of bribery. People who are to take their legitimate money from the government and the application is filed there, certain percentage was deducted and was distributed right from the Attorney General to the Accountant General to the peon. They are so good at accounts, so they know what proportion who should get. Now Uba Khen is Accountant General, such a dhamma person, not possible. And he was a very strict disciplinarian. He issued an order that any application comes to the office, the concerned person must give a decision within 48 hours. If there is a complication, one cannot take a decision, bring it to me. I will take decision. One is not taking decision, not bringing the case to me, has bad intentions. He will be dismissed. But that alone did not work. It was dhamma. In his office itself, he started teaching Vipassana. He went to the Prime Minister and told him, sir, you made me Accountant General, good. But look, there is so much corruption everywhere. And unless people practice Vipassana, they can't live a real moral life, a good life. Permit me to have one room where a few workers of this office every month take a course of 10 days. The Prime Minister was also a very good dharmic person. He wanted the administration to become very pure, good. He says, all right, go ahead. And every month there is a 10-day Vipassana course in the office of Accountant General. And that started giving result. In a few years' time, it was a talk of the town that in Accountant General's office there is no more bribery, no more corruption. And the Prime Minister calls Uba Khen. How is it? But is it good or bad? It's very good, Uba Khen. But I want this to happen in other ministries, other departments. Look, that department, this department. Sir, I am a civil servant, you transfer me there. I will start working the same thing there also. Oh, no, no. If I transfer you somewhere, then again this department will sink. So you be here. And at the same time, you look after this, you look after that. There was a time when he was head of 4 departments. So huge responsibility. And yet, kept on working so smilingly, giving wonderful results everywhere. It was said about him that in whichever department he will go for 1 hour or 2 hours or 5 hours, and any number of files that will come, any number of cases that will come on his table, when he leaves that office, not a single case is there on the table. He gives decision on every case, however complicated it may be. The mind becomes so clean. Any problem, you can go to the depth of the problem and give a quick result and right result. The capacity increases manifold. One works so much. Vipassana does not make one inactive. One becomes so active. capacity to work so much, people keep on asking me that this teaching is not to crave, not to have attachment. Without craving, without attachment, how can you work? How can anybody work? People work because they crave. People work because they have good attachment. Oh, because you have not learned how to work in a detached way. When you are attached, you are so tense inside, you are so self-centered. I'm working for me, for me, for me. And once you become detached, all tension goes away. Now you work. Although you work for your own livelihood, for those who depend on you to serve them, but then a bigger outlook is there. What am I working? I am working for others also. Look, so many people are getting benefited. So many people are getting... Your mind is not narrow now, it is so broad. Capacity to work increases. All the tensions go away. Mind is so clear, so tranquil. You make good decisions, right decisions.